Hi, my name is Robin Wong. I want to invite you to come with me to do insect macro photography. I will share as much as I can in this video, so let's have some fun. Before we start, I want to remind everyone to be respectful of nature. Be respectful to flora, fauna, try not to do unnecessary damage, don't break the branches, don't pluck the leaves, don't touch the insects, don't move them, don't interfere with their lives. This is their home, this is their habitat. Please be respectful of all the insects and of everything you found in the jungle. My technical execution is very simple. I hold the camera with one hand and the flash with the other. I will place the light slightly above the head of the insect, a little bit to the side, just like how you would do a studio photography. The reason why I use the wireless flash technique is because insects or bugs will not stay on top of a leaf under the bright hot sun, willingly pose and wait for you. All right, just like human beings, when it's too hot, they will find somewhere cool to hide, usually under heavy shade, sometimes beneath a leaf, sometimes deep into the bushes. So these are the places where on-camera flash is difficult to reach. By taking the flash off the camera, I can control the direction of my light, I can bring the light everywhere I want to, and that is the reason why, to me, wireless flash is important for macro photography. For this demonstration, I'm using my camera, the Olympus OMD EM1 Mark II, with the clip-on flash attached, the FL-LM3. That was quite a mouthful. I also have the Olympus M.Zuiko 60mm f2.8 macro lens. The external flash that I use is the Olympus FL-50R. I know that this is an outdated model, but I've been using this flash for more than 10 years now and it has not failed me. I've done so many commercial jobs and personal shoots with this flash. Now, I attach the Gamilight square mini softbox. It doesn't have to be any brand, any softbox, or you can even DIY your own diffuser, right? That's half of the fun of doing insect macro. I generally keep my camera settings simple and straightforward. The shutter speed is between 1 over 100 to 1 over 250, depending on how much ambient light I want to collect. The aperture is about f5.6 to f13. The smaller the subject is, the closer I move to the insect or bug, the bigger the f number will have to be to achieve sufficient depth of field, meaning that I want as much as possible to be in focus. I maintain my ISO at ISO 200 all the time, mainly because this is the base ISO for the EM1 Mark II, and I prioritize dynamic range in my shots since I will be using flash for all my insect macro shooting. How to activate the wireless flash? Go to menu, camera menu 2, find the RC mode down there, turn it on. Right, once it's on, you will have this RC icon at the top of your screen. Press OK button to get to the menu and make sure that the groups and the channels on the camera is the same as it is on the flash. On the external flash, make sure that you have the correct mode. Cycle it to the RC mode and make sure that the channel and the groupings are similar to the ones displayed on the camera. Now that we are ready, let's attack some bugs. Let's start with this spider here hiding behind the leaf. I need to hold the camera steady. It is actually easier than I thought since we have the powerful 5-axis image stabilization. So it's not too difficult. Always review the shots after each take, just to make sure that everything is in focus. Check for critical focus. Even if it's slightly missed, you can always retake the shot. All right. We have another spider here, posing nicely on top of a leaf. Okay, let's go in. Notice the angle of where I place my light. It is always above the subject, slightly angled to the side. Alright, that is to simulate where the light of the sun was coming from. Now we have this tiny red spider. Ooh, it's missing some legs. Ouch. But yeah, it looks pretty cool. This is perhaps the tiniest thing I have encountered today. Look at the size of my finger at the back. It's crazy. It's so tiny. So I'm actually utilizing the maximum magnification of this lens. To be honest, it's not easy shooting at such large magnification, and I do need to go to F13. Yeah, some folks will complain about diffraction and loss of sharpness, but honestly, who cares? Look at the details. Everything is still intact, right? And I like the patterns of the web the spider is on. Okay, let's look through all the photographs I've taken today. That's all I have for today. I hope you have found my insect macro photography sharing useful. If you have your own tips or if you have your own techniques you want to share, I would love to hear from you. Please share in the comments below. If you want to see more videos like this of me doing photography tutorials or sharing my tips and techniques on doing certain things, please let me know in the comments below as well. It has been fun. I hope you pick up insect macro photography if you have not. And always remember to go out and take photographs and have fun. Thank you so much.